particularly to Dr. The first speaker. I'm not sure what his name, you know, and Dr. Manion Chan. We keep saying, I fully agree that technology and innovations are neutral across borders, across regions. But we forgot to mention also the governance, the issue of governance, management. Dr. Manion Chan did mention it. You know, so it's, we should not have a negative view that this is a threat. Or it's very much depends to the, it's not the guns, but the man behind the gun. It means the government. The issue of governance is very much at hand. Even Singapore, also such a small city state, and good governance and all this, it's very difficult in managing the income, relative income inequality, because it's a lot of them are all across border. So therefore, this comes back to the second comments. In one of the prepared questions, you mentioned it, what can a single country do, does to minimize income inequality? Nobody can do it. Not one country. That's the whole idea of community, the region. That's why last night I mentioned it to Harawakisan and to the others, that I personally, I would mention it also in the next panel, that in fact, actually, I think we have to bring it down the multilateral into regional. And the bilateral, all those facilitation, ecotech, all move it up, upgrade it to regional. No one single country can do it because of the vast rapid changes in technology. So therefore, you need a cooperative development, as Professor Zhang Yunling mentioned. So these three points are very important. One more point, Dr. Joseph Yap. You mentioned it that the cross-cutting issue is higher education, right? It's not a higher education. This is the problem in the Philippines and keenly realized in the Singapore. It's not just higher education, but it's a relevant. Like for example, in Singapore, in we don't have we had only one university in 1992, only National University of Singapore, and then 1993 they opened up Nanyang Technological University, because we don't need so many universities. But we have seven polytechnics, because at that different stage of the development, you require a different skill and a profile of skill. So higher education is very much is an abstract description, but you need to really go into the detail. So it means a more practical, hands-on training in polytechnic, and probably in later on after polytechnics, then they move up to research on hands-on and practical innovation that create jobs, not only just create diploma